Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, is the Lord's, and the faithfulness thereof. The world and they will dwell therein. And everyone, glory be to thee, O God. The Lord is good to all, and his tender mercies are over all his works.
Glory be to thee, O God.
Enter into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him, and bless his name.
Praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Praise him, all creatures here below. Praise him above, ye heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost.
Father God, yes, we do praise you, and we thank you, Lord. We ask that you would bless these gifts, Father God, bless the gift and the giver, that these gifts would be used for your service and your service only, Lord, that they would go forth to benefit the kingdom and the kingdom work that you have set forth for us. And we thank you for this in your Son, Jesus' name. Amen. May you see. We can stand for this. Blessed Assurance.
Blessed Assurance. The ways of God. He was against the salvation. And so the Lord had stricken him
to see you so that I may impart some spiritual gift to you, that you may be established. That is, that I may be encouraged together with you while among you, each of us, by the faith, by the other's faith, both yours and mine. For I am not ashamed of the gospel, for it is the power of God for salvation to everyone who believes in Jesus, for the Jews first and also to the Greeks. For in the righteousness of God, revealed from faith to faith, as it is written, but the righteous man shall live by faith. Did you come expecting today? I'm sure we all came expecting. What? We don't know. Expecting something. Let's start with the basics of faith. In this walk, in this life, do you feel a purpose? Is there a purpose in your life? Deep within, we all seek and desire to have a purpose in our life. Somewhere in there, we're always asking the question, or maybe not always, but often asking the question, what does God have for me? What do you have for me, Lord? There's some kingdom work to be done out there. And through that question, there's another question of how do I see myself? Do I see myself as being able to do this kingdom work? Am I worthy? Or is some guilt or shame or something of my past holding me back from being able to step up and speak of God or to even feel like I can be useful for God? Because quite often, there's situations, and I'm sure each and every one of us could say in our life, where we just might not have felt that we were worthy or able or upright enough to be able to do God's work. Well, thank God for the blood of Jesus Christ, as it has washed each and every one of us whiter than snow, for those who believe. And for those who accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior and do sincerely believe in his promise for eternal life, we're imparted the gift. Paul mentions here about imparting unto you the gifts. Each and every one of our gifts, some of us haven't even touched the surface of what our gifts are. We don't know. But on the day when needed, the Lord will reveal these gifts to us, as he probably has with many of you in the past. You do much treasuring. Molly, you're putting together a lot here for the church, taking the time. As I had said to Molly earlier, she's 17, she's in school, she could do whatever she wants. Oh, God, I want to go play with friends. I want to go be with friends. I want to do this. But you know what? She's acknowledging that gift inside of her, and the Spirit is speaking to her. And she's doing the work of the kingdom. It's kingdom work that she's doing. Corey organizing. Brandy, secretary. Tom, taking care of things. Bonnie, what are you doing? You're a teacher. You're a teacher. You teach many. And I'm sure that you teach many in a way that you don't even realize, as just the glow and the expressions from you come that are soft and gentle. That's that Spirit within you. That's the Holy Spirit within you. To handle things as you see, gently, with love. John gets everyone there safely. John drives the kids there safely. And in the meantime, John's off doing this and that. So our gifts are within us. Sometimes we don't even recognize these gifts as they're gifts from God. But when you're doing it for the kingdom, when you're doing it for kingdom works, it's a different meaning. And bring to light that meaning. Let us take the pictures of the good in our life and past, of things that have come about and what we have done. You know, Lord, not to boast in myself, but to boast in what you have done through me and for me today. We think about it. We don't take the time to just sit back and taste, savor the flavor of the goodness and the fruits of God, the Spirit that dwells within each and every one of us. Some of us think we have a stony heart from time to time, but you know that's why the Lord is here, to soften those stony hearts, to break that ground. And, you know, often when we don't recognize these gifts, at church and we have fellowship afterwards. Paul mentions in there, you know, it's important to encourage one another. As we speak to one another, we're encouraging one another with fellow believers. And even those that aren't believers, they look at and they see there's just something about that person. There's something more about them. I want to know what that is. As we reflect the love of Christ, we're a mirror. The Spirit within us shines. Get that glow about us, especially when we're really enthused about doing the Lord's business. Iron sharpens iron. It's a well-known phrase in the Bible in Proverbs, Proverbs 27. Iron sharpens iron, so one man sharpens another. And as we sharpen each other, that's when we're building up these gifts that God has given us, the gifts that are within us. Sometimes it will take someone else to fan that flame. When the fire is getting low, but the wood is on there, and it's just not burning hot enough, we fan that flame, don't we? Well, there's a fire within us, that Holy Ghost fire, that Holy Spirit fire. Sometimes we just need to feed that flame. We need to fan it. We need to get it to burn a little bit hotter. Those are times when we just have to get involved with prayer. Stop. Step back. Away from the storms. And savor that flavor. Fan that flame. Say, Lord, I need that buildup right now. I need to feel you. I'm just not feeling it. And it's not, there's nothing wrong with not feeling that. We all get that. So it's nothing to be ashamed of. But we need to recognize that. And the more we stay in touch with one another, the more that we recognize, I need to fan this flame. I need to fan the fires of my heart. And that builds it up. That fire gets burning. Boy, we just feel good. Sometimes I get to the feeling where I'm balling over. I just feel so filled with something. I can almost jump, you know? Well, we won't go there. I don't want to pick on these other churches, but we won't go there. But that's the feeling. That's the Lord wants us to feel that. That's excitement. That's being enthusiastic about what God has for us with that Spirit within us. There's that gift. That gift is the Holy Spirit. Jesus, when he spoke with his disciples as he was getting ready to go onto the cross, and he said to them, I will be leaving you, but don't worry. I will be leaving with you the Holy Spirit to encourage you, to give you the wisdom, to teach you, to guide you. But if that fire's not burning, there's no guidance. There's no teaching. But iron sharpens iron as one man sharpens another through that fellowship. That's a fanning of the flames. That's a sharpening of the Spirit of the sword. And the Spirit within us is being fed. I'm sure you have heard the story about the black dog and the white dog, and the two of them are battling and fighting. And the black dog said, you know what? I'm going to let this dog just starve. So when he gets into that fighting ring, he's going to be vicious, mean, and hungry. And the man with the white dog says, I'm going to feed this dog, and I'm going to train him right how to be a good fighter, the moves to make it. I'm going to give him the healthiest and the best foods. I think it's rather obvious which one is going to win the fight. The one that is nourished, the one that is fed, the one that is trained. We fellowship. We come to service. We're feeding that Spirit. We're learning more about the Spirit of God. We're learning more about that gift of God as we speak with one another. So we go out into this world. We are conquerors. Why are we conquerors? Because we nourish that Spirit. The white dog. We are the white dog. And we're amongst thieves, we're amongst dogs. Often in Proverbs and different books, it speaks of the dogs of this world. That's the evil. That's the bad. And this is a battle. We're up against that. And if you don't want to admit and you don't want to face the fact of that, this is a good and evil. It's a very fine line. But even though it's a fine line, it don't matter if that line is the finest of microscopic lines, to the boldest of walls, the fine line is have right and we have wrong. What really lets us know this? In our heads, in our hearts. The Spirit, the gift that God gave us. Again, fan those flames. It's a guide. It helps us to get through each day to know what our part is in doing kingdom work. So in the beginning I asked, did you feel useful for God? Do you know your use for God? If you don't, it'll be revealed. But already you have been useful for God. Really? You mean I've already been useful for God? And you think about it, y'all, I have been. Let that encourage you. Let the fact of what we have done already for God be useful in God's kingdom. This is what God asks of us. He don't ask much. He just asks that we acknowledge Him and love Him. Acknowledging Him and loving Him, from that point, He has the rest. He has the rest. How many of the people and prophets and in the past and in the Old and New Testament wondered, what do I do? How do I? Why do I? Because God has imparted that within you. Paul spoke in this very reading here. May I impart to you the gifts. That's imparted within each and every one of us. Take those pictures that are in our minds and highlight each and every one of them that is of goodness. Take all that negative that wants to hold you down, and like on a computer, you got a computer screen of pictures. Click, delete, click, delete, click, delete, and let just the good pictures come forth. Not that we're not facing a reality of there is bad that has happened to us. Not that we want to try to put on a facade. But let's keep it in a positive note. We can always take all the things and let them weigh us down that have happened bad in the past. I walked around with a burden on my back that was heavier than I can imagine. And when I come to know the Lord, and I laid those burdens down at the foot of the cross, I realized God has a purpose for me. I let the ways of this world weigh me down. It blinded me. I was so weighed down by everything that I couldn't pick my head up to see what God is, what God has, and what God has already done. Don't let the weight of this world bring you down. Don't let the weight of this world blind you from the truth of what you have. We're all good inside. Each and every one of us has good inside of us. But do we give ourselves credit for it? Well, if you don't, you should. Is God going to want us to feel down, beaten up, and torn apart? God wants us to feel bold, strong, and alive, because that's the Spirit that He has dwelled within us. He has given that Spirit to us. Why? Why would God do that to me? Because He loves us. He's our Creator. But all He asks is that we acknowledge Him, and we love Him, and we be about His business. Kingdom work. We doing the work of the kingdom today? That's a question you can ask yourself. The answer to that? There's an answer this big, there's answers this big. Your answer is somewhere in between. But you know, no matter what the answer is, there's a difference that we can make each and every one of our lives. By knowing who we are and who dwells within us, deep within us. Let it not be so deep, but let that come to the surface. Let that Spirit shine about each and every one of us as we do our small tasks, as we do our big tasks. Again, Bonnie teaching. I'm sure that there's a little glow about you out there. just in how you act with your attitude in approaching different situations. You see a child that needs help. Maybe he needs a little bit extra help. There might be a little bit of an issue there. John, have you ever gotten out of your seat and helped a kid get on or off the bus? You have? God bless you. See? The simple things like that. Wendy, I'm not sure exactly the make of that car. I just know that the year is this year and it's a such and such. Did you go outside and check? Corey? Not sure what vehicle I want, but I know I want something that's going to do this. Dylan? Something's wrong with the computer here. It's acting funny. Can you help me? Can you fix it? Have you done that? You've done that for others? There's the simple little tasks that we can give God the glory for giving us that knowledge and that ability to do these. You know? So in those little things, to us it might just seem so little. But you know, I'm sure God the Father is up there saying, oh, it's so good to see them doing something for the kingdom. Showing others my love. Helping others instead of saying, I'm not helping that person. So what? Let them trip and fall getting on the bus. I'm just doing what I'm paid to do. Simple things like that. It's just it's a blessing when we just realize and recognize what's being done. You know? We cut grass. We take care of trees. We set up ornaments. This whole thing's like that. That means so much. Whew. Who are we in Christ? And what can I do to be called to do the kingdom work? You know, the more we believe in what we say, is the more those pictures of the negativity fade away. And the more that we do realize and recognize how useful I am. But Paul also says in these verses, for I am not ashamed of the gospel. Are you able to confidently and boldly speak of your spiritual beliefs? Or do you keep quiet when you hear somebody speaking of difficulties that they're having with a situation that they're in or whatever it might be? Do you feel confident enough in your faith to go over and tell them, hey, you know, I'd like to share something with you. I'd like to let you know what God has done for me. And I know the world wants to reject them. A lot of parts of the world, people don't even want to hear about God. But that's where the light has to shine really bright. Paul, on the road to Damascus, was struck with a bright light that blinded him. So he couldn't even see to go any further to persecute people who were worshiping Christ and honoring God. He was struck with a bright light that gave him a blindness. And he asked, who are you? I am Jesus, the one you persecute. Well, this is what the world needs to see. They need to be blinded by the negative, by the positive that's within us to blind out that negative that they might be going through. I think it's really important that we have that boldness and that security and the confidence in our faith and in what we believe in. Because if you truly believe in something, then you will be bold about it. With each and every one of us, with our spouses, or with a good friend, and you know something about that friend that's sure, and you know that it's good, but somebody will come up and try to say something bad, try to give that little nudge of negativity, try to break it down to demean it. With our spouses and with friends, do we not stand up and say, how do you even know? You don't know that about them. That's a lie. up like that for God today. Let's have that faith and the confidence to stand in faith today and each and every day as we go throughout our lives. These are definitely the times of dark. And Jesus needs to be heard and seen. Because I can stand up here, and again, for I am not without sin. That's for sure. But let us not just tell people about God and Jesus and the Holy Spirit and the works of the kingdom, but let us also let this be seen. Anybody could be a mouthpiece. Anybody could just speak of what they want to speak of. But it is more difficult to actually do. Doing is the part that really means more than just saying. If you would, for a minute, open up your Bibles to 1 Corinthians 13. Often this chapter is called the love chapter. But in this first verse, if I speak with the tongues of men and of angels, but do not have love, I have become a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and I know all the mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains but do not have love, I am nothing. You want to be something today? You want to be something, someone? Let's do. Let's be doers of the word. Not just hearers and speakers of the word. Let us be something today. Because God wants each and every one of us to be something today. That's why he gave us his son. That's why his only son shed his blood on the cross. So that we can be free from the condemnation of this world and not fall underneath all of those ways that people want to try to put us in a box. But let's come out of that box. Let's shine the light around this world today. And let's walk and do the work for God as we enter into this kingdom, as we enter into each situation. Let us keep in mind that the Holy Spirit is within us. Fan those flames, all right? Give a little spark today. Give that heart a little bit of an extra bump today. Forget the negative. We're not falling underneath that negativity. Jesus died. His blood was shed. I am cleansed. I am washed whiter than snow. I do not have to remain all under the negative ways that my mind wants me to see. Our mind can be our worst enemy. But then again, we have the will. God gave us free will. And that will, and part of that will, is to choose. Who do I want to be today? Where do I see myself? If you see yourself in a position, then go all the way and see yourself in the position. Because if you don't see yourself there, you're never going to really get there. You have to see yourself. You have to have a vision of it first. Then you go about it. The vision is our map. God's given us a map. It's on the tablets of our hearts. So be useful. Have a purpose and a purposeful meaning for God today. And we're going to go to our little brochure with the ending song. Let me get to my downloads here. And shine, Jesus, shine. Yeah, please, yeah. and we praise you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen.